What's the most shocking thing about TV Guide?
That it exists?
Yes, that it still even exists. How is TV Guide? You hear it? Listen. He's leafing through a TV Guide. He has a physical. Is this a? How long have you subscribed to TV Guide?
I've had it for about 2 months.
Is it week? Does it come weekly?
No, it's. I think it's bi-monthly, and I got it because I started getting into TV more. I never used to watch a lot of TV, but I'm so fatigued from the news coverage, from my own pandemic news coverage and TV coverage, that I need a distraction. So I'm watching more TV and movies, more TV than movies.
Yeah, because every TV has a guide on it now, right? Every cable provider, satellite, you hit a little button and the guide pops up on the TV. So the fact that TV Guide even still exists as a physical thing that you can hold is crazy to me. Now, is it still the same size? It was kind of like that smaller on the small.
No, it's actually bigger.
It's bigger than
like
it used
to be. Like a
whole
magazine?
Yeah, probably because the elderly have poor eyesight.
True.
And need to see bigger print. But
now, let me ask you this. It's obviously a TV guide. What percentage of that publication is actually the guide as opposed to other things that you can read?
Oh, well, there's – I don't really look at the guide that much. The thing I look at is the description of the movies and TV shows that they recommend. So the descriptions, I would say, is about 33%.
Okay. I'm just trying to gauge what the hell this even is anymore.
Yeah.
Like, because you said that you go through and you fold down the pages. Now, what pages have you earmarked to, like, go back to?
Okay. Well, I folded down and circled with a Sharpie.
Oh.
Today, It's a Wonderful Life at 8 p.m. on NBC, WBAL TV 11. See? Every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings, just in case you didn't know that.
So that's in the actual guide. You circled the...
This is in the description section. It has a name. What is it? Oh, it's called What's Worth Watching. And they break it up into week one, week two, etc.
Does it provide a description?
Yes.
Can you read the description
for
It's a Wonderful Life?
Every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings. And every time holiday season comes around, It's a Wonderful Life makes us grateful. Of course, it wasn't always so. It's well known that Frank Capra's 1946 drama about a man, James Stewart, who thinks everyone would be better off if he'd never been born, bombed upon release. Oh, I didn't know that. What's really shocking, Carolyn Grimes, the actress who played young Zuzu, didn't watch the film until she was 39. So you get some interesting facts with
it. Little tidbits. Let me ask you this in What's Worth Watching section. What have you circled that is new to you? That you were reading through and you saw something. You're like, oh, I've never heard of this before. I will now watch, give this a shot.
Okay. Some of it, I'm not certain I'll watch it, but it caught my attention.
Right.
So I might take a look. December 25th on A&E.
Tomorrow.
Live Rescue Top 20 Moments of 2020. Over 2 hours, the docuseries replays. God, I can't. It's too dark in here. It's like the biggest, the most dramatic rescues of the year. Rescue divers looking in a submerged car, medics going to a shooting scene. So that's tomorrow on A&E.
Well, you know what live rescue is, right? You know what that is? That took place of.
Yeah, live.
It's
PD.
Live PD.
I thought that might have been it.
Which I tried to get you to watch a gazillion times. It's basically they took live PD off the air because, you know, with everything that was going on in 2020, they took the PD down. So then they redid it with live rescue.
Are you like me, Scott, where you find yourself resentful of live rescue? Because I am. I'm resentful of it.
I wish it was live PD. I see it, and I'm just like, you know what? Thank you, but I wish you were something else.
Mm-hmm. Now, this is a show I've already started watching, but I just wanted to point out to you guys that it's so popular. It's mentioned in TV Guide. Uh-huh. Sunday, Your Honor on Showtime with Bryan Cranston.
I'm not making that Showtime money.
Oh, neither am I. But I heard about it, and I'm watching it. And I'm not actually, as it goes on, I'm not convinced that it's going to be as good as it seemed, but I'm committed till the end.
Now, who did you say was on the cover of this biweekly?
It's Mayim Bialik.
That's right. Are you going to watch that new show?
No, I'm not a fan of hers.
Okay, because she's Jewish.
Yeah, that doesn't do it for me, especially not on Christmas Eve. Mm-hmm. Here's one I circled: The Midnight Sky, which debuted yesterday on Netflix. George Clooney, he plays a scientist on Earth. He survived some sort of global catastrophe, and there's a spaceship, and he has to warn them not to come back to Earth. I actually watched it yesterday.
You watched it?
Yeah, on its debut day.
Whoa. All right. And?
Out of 5 stars, I'd give it 2.5 stars.
Oh.
But it's one of those things where it's not either or. It's not like don't watch it or do watch it. I'd say if you want to kill some time, watch it. You might like not think it's great, but it'll give you something to do.
Right.
I'm not going to watch a show that you gave 2.5 stars to. I respect
you might
your
like
opinion.
It.
I would. If you gave
you
it
might.
Two and a
I
half.
Don't know. It's look. I don't know everything, but you might like it.
Well, I've only know one person that's watched it, and they gave it 2.5 stars, and that's you.
Oh, you know what I watched also last night on Netflix? I was flipping around Netflix. Have you seen this? The Tudors?
The Tudors? No.
T-U-D-O-R-S? No.
It's
about a king?
Show, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's a good show.
No.
You know who's
there's
comedian,
a lot. There's a lot of new. There's a lot of nudity.
Oh,
there.
A little
there's
some
a lot of nudity.
There's some bubbies? There's some bubbies?
I saw two sets of nipples.
Wow.
Like on two different women in just the first episode.
Wow.
There's big stars in that show.
Yeah.
The Tudors. Yeah. Henry Cavill's in it. I believe that. Isn't he?
Oh, okay. I thought I recognized
Superman,
him.
Superman, yeah.
Anything else? How are you? We got to wrap up. We got to get to your news. But so you're in. You're fully in on the TV Guide subscription. What does it cost?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
How long do you sign? How do you even subscribe? I mean, I'm on the website, I guess, here. Join, sign up. Sign up to get started. How did you even
I'll give
this?
You just a couple of others if you want. Wonder Woman 1984, which is huge. HBO Max, that debuts Christmas Day. The Godfather Marathon on AMC on December 30th. Then, of course, you've got all the New Year's Eve specials on New Year's Eve. This is big. This is big. This is on our sister TV station, MeTV. Saturday morning cartoons. They're bringing them back.
Whoa.
Tom and Jerry and the gang. Bugs
Stop!
Bunny and Frank gang. Popeye and pals.
Dude.
That's January 2nd. And one other one. This one you might be interested in. Worst Cooks in America.
Oh, yeah,
season premiere on Food Network. Oh, is that not a new show?
No, that's been on for years.
Yes, Sunday, January 3rd is the season premiere. So that's everything I circled with a Sharpie.
I'll tell you what, it kind of distills it down, and it gives
I love that. I love TV Guide.
It's like you already gave me 3 or 4 things that I was like, you know, I wouldn't have known that otherwise, right?
Would you like to know what a subscription costs?
Please.
Do you know, Josh? Do you even know what you
Well,
pay?
I may have gotten a deal because of, you know, they may have solicited me. Uh-huh. You know, sometimes you get a deal versus
a deal.
Yeah, what does it cost?
Well, here's the best deal that you can get, and that's $40.
Oh no, I didn't pay $40
for a year?
For 2 years.
Oh, that's not bad.
Okay.
No.
And it includes 8 free weeks, and you get I don't know if you got this, Josh. You get a free exclusive organizer tote.
Did you get an organizer tote?
Did you get an organizer tote?
I did not get a tote, and I did not commit for 2 years, that's for sure.
Yeah, no.
But if they asked me now, you're damn right I'd commit. It's a hell of a publication.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.